this radiation, he's a radiation specialist from the Netherlands, is saying they need to know, they need to be releasing data on the exact isotopes and the amounts that's coming out of Fukushima and Daiichi, and have been coming out of Fukushima Daiichi for months now. Listen to the government's response. Listen to the Japanese government's response, because it's a peach, man. It's a peach, and it just shows you. It shows you the contempt that they have towards the Japanese public. This is the government response. The government plans to release details on the radiation released at the appropriate time. The government plans to release details on the radiation released at the appropriate time, said Gonshi Hamasho, an advisor to Prime Minister Natokan. So when would you think an appropriate time would be? In the middle of a nuclear disaster?
Workers at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant say they are not being protected from exposure to radiation. They tell NHK that the Tokyo Electric Power Company, or TEPCO's safety measures are shoddy. This worker says safety is not the company's first priority. Another worker says the company's reckless and the workers are just disposable items. Workers at the plant say they have been exposed to internal radiation. Internal exposure results when people breathe or eat radioactive substances. The radioactive materials remain in the internal organs over long periods of time, and the individual is exposed to the radiation for this duration. Devices are available to show how much internal exposure a person has been subject to. This machine measures the volume of radiation emitted per minute. The unit measured is called a count. TEPCO standard calls for further checking if the count surpasses 1,500. More thorough examination is needed for counts above 7,500. The count for the initial team was extremely high at 5,000 to 8,000 counts per minute. One worker measured 80,000 or 50 times the danger criterion.
This worker says you can't see radiation, but when the symptoms arise 2 or 3 years later, people will regret it. The masks used at the construction site were defective. The workers wore full face masks. The worker who had been exposed bumped into a scaffold at the plant and his filter came off and he inhaled radioactive air. He says the filter comes off when the mask is bumped, and when it comes off, the person ends up inhaling outside air. The worker's lounge area was also a hazard. The rest area was located in a seismic isolation building. The same building was the site of the emergency response headquarters. At the time, the entrance of the building had been warped because of the earthquake, and the door did not close fully at first. Radioactive material came in from outside, and radiation levels were high in the building. The effort to grasp the internal radiation exposure among power plant workers has made almost no progress. The Health and Labor Ministry says only 1/5 of the 7,000 plant workers have so far undergone the test for radiation exposure. Some of the workers did not even know of the need for an internal radiation check. These two workers say their company told them they would be working at a thermal power plant, but were instead taken to the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. This worker says he was surprised to see people at the plant all wearing white clothes and face masks. realized he would also be required to wear the same clothing.
Glenn said it was the first time to work at a nuclear power plant. He was assigned to remove debris near a reactor in
an area where high radiation doses were detected.
Initially, he was working without a dosimeter. He was given nothing to record his radiation dose. 会社に不安を訴え、ようやく内部被曝の測定を受けられることになりました。
それ
で
どれだけ
浴びているのかもわかんないし、やっぱこれからそういうのが不安ですね。
こうした状況に専門家は、こうした状況に専門家は、
Here's what an expert had to say.
まあ、一番重要なことは放射性物質を体の中に吸い込まない、体の中に入れないようにするということに最大の努力を払うべきだと思います、ね、これから気温が高くなってきますのでどうしても暑くなりますね。汗で
吸えてしまうということです。ただ
環境を良くしていかないと被曝を防ぐような体制にならないんじゃないかと思います。
東京電力は内部被曝の問題を把握しているとした上で、通常は3ヶ月に1回の検査の回数を増やすとともに、作業員全員に検査を徹底したいと話しています。基準を超える内部被曝が分かった作業員たち、原発に近い町に住み、長い人では30年以上も原発で働いていました。内部被曝の不安を抱えながらも、原発事故を収束させた、と今も救済に当たっています。
This worker says the company may be more concerned about the nuclear plant than about the people who are working there.
He says nothing can be done without workers. He says there must be people willing to take the risk of working here. He also says he wonders if TEPCO knows how difficult it is to work at the nuclear plant under these circumstances.